There's no doubt that there's election fraud going on in this country. There's been countless examples of it going back to Kennedy in 1960 and the fraud up in Illinois. We know about LBJ in Texas to get into Congress and fraud. We know about what happened in the 2000 election. It's been certified in Ohio that it was fraud in 2004. But now with Ron Paul, it is undoubted. He clearly won in Iowa. And a month after that election, they just threw the whole thing out and haven't said what they're going to do now, but admitted that a bunch of the precincts had their records disappear. Everywhere like Ames, where he was showing 55-60% in the polls, all those college university areas. Then we saw the incredible fraud that took place in Nevada, where Ron Paul in most polls was number one, but came out number three. And then, of course, we saw what happened in Maine. There's many other examples, but in Maine, he was polling number one in almost every poll, some polls number two. And then he came out, of course, losing in Maine. And now he's challenged it, and so they're having to go back and say, oh, we did say that Romney had won with only a few percentage points in. And oh, a whole bunch of counties, the counties that were college areas and others that were polling the highest, they just didn't get counted that night. That's exactly what happened in Iowa, exactly what happened in Nevada. It's exactly what's happening all over this country. And finally, Ron Paul is challenging it. Listen, Stalin said, I don't care who votes. I care who counts the votes. We have a government that lied about WMDs, a government caught stealing and lying constantly. We'd be idiots to believe known liars who've been caught engaged in fraud. We've had diebold programmers come out and say it's a scam. We've seen so much evidence of this. But the reason we got behind Ron Paul was so we could put out the message of liberty and freedom and ending the private Federal Reserve and stopping this empire that we pay for. So he's won by running, and he's winning by illustrating how much fraud there is. But let me get into more evidence of the fact that Ron Paul is really number one. First off, they told us he couldn't win. They told us he was going to lose. They told us that it would throw away our vote if we supported him, and he wasn't even in the running. And still, he won all the straw polls. Still, he got the most overall donations from small independent donors, showing true grassroots support. And despite that controlled corporate media mantra that he couldn't win, that worked 4 years ago, it failed, and he was still in that top tier. But here's the biggest piece of evidence of fraud. Not just the fact that he was given the least amount of time in the debates, 89 seconds at the CBS, so that when he does get coverage, it's incredibly negative. No, it's that consistently in the last year, he's gotten more money, even though there were 8 Republican candidates early on, and it still shows the numbers today with only 4 left. Ron Paul, in the last year, has gotten over 70% of all total donations from the military for all Republicans and Obama. And that's the big secret they don't want you to know about. Now, what does that illustrate? That where it's a straw poll, or where it's a scientific poll, or where it's flat-out donations, he's winning in every indicator that they haven't been able to game or corrupt yet. They can only game their electronic voting machines, or in the case of Iowa or other areas, he even wins the precincts, but then they don't report them in and say the truck got lost. There were no trucks in Iowa. They vote right there, they post the results, call it in. But they said a bunch of trucks got lost everywhere he was winning by double digits. Same thing now happened in Maine. So he's winning. And that last piece of evidence, getting all those military donations, people like Adam Kokesh and other veterans had a march. Thousands and thousands showed up of active duty. Almost no corporate or media coverage. Again, showing they'll game things, showing they'll cover things up. In the debates, they attack him and say, you don't support the wars, you don't support the military, implying the military supports all these illegal wars, when in all the polls show they don't. Imagine if another candidate who was a warmonger had this type of military support. That's all you'd hear about. So it shows that the military is waking up, so are the police. They understand that criminals have taken over our government. And so it's a process. Even if Ron Paul doesn't win because of fraud, he is America's real president. And it shows that the ideas of sovereignty and anti-globalism and true freedom worldwide, 1776 worldwide, is the answer. Now, I'm on the road traveling to Orlando to speak this next Sunday. I'll be doing reports for the nightly news. I'll be doing my radio show live from the road every day at 11 a.m. Central, 12 noon Eastern. But when I get back, I'm going to compile a huge report with all the evidence of fraud, with all the graphs and numbers to show this to you and break it down. But you've all seen it for yourself. But get the word out. We know that there's massive election fraud. We know the black boxes are kicking in. We know the scams are taking place. And our entire process of being a constitutional republic and the people being able to vote is in deep trouble. But look, Congress has a 9% approval rating for 2 years running now, lowest in history, and it's only going to get lower. Of course it's fraud. Most people are awake and angry, but still, the corporate welfare, the wars, the corruption, the gun grabbing, the fast and furious, all of it, the socialist health care, it only gets worse regardless of what we do, because the fix is in many areas. They don't have these machines in everywhere. And where they just don't count the caucus votes. They've got their people in everywhere. And everywhere libertarians and constitutionalists try to run locally, the feds, minions are there trying to block them. But more and more they're failing, in the case of Rand Paul and others. That's why you've got to run for local office. You've got to be a watchdog. You've got to take over the bureaucracy yourself so that more and more we can expose what they're doing. So look how far we've grown. Ron Paul 10 years ago couldn't get one co-sponsor to off the Fed. Passed the House last year, killed in the Senate. He's almost got the votes again this year. The idea is out. The liberty is there. That's why top globalist Brzezinski says the elite has never been in this much trouble. All right, I'm Alex Jones reporting for Infowars.com. Please get this video out to everybody, because knowing is half the battle. Being aware of what they're doing is half the battle, and getting out of our denial and saying no and waking up. Here's the evidence. You've seen it. Now the rest is up to you. Get out there and expose what's happening.